Okay guys, so once again we are back to the cluster components. Till now we have understood the cluster from normal diagrams, but let us get a little bit inside a cluster. What is a cluster and what are the components of a cluster and how a cluster is made? First of all, the main important component of a cluster is cluster nodes. If you don't have cluster nodes, definitely you cannot combine or make a cluster. It's a single machine which actually participates in the cluster. So you have nodes, and every machine that is part of the cluster is called as node. And each node is responsible for providing the processing resources. It's not your network, it's not your Clusterware software, it's basically the single node that processes the information at ground level. So every node is responsible to process the information, and who allocates the work to the nodes? It is the Clusterware software. Performs actual work in the cluster, same hardware configuration. So make sure every node in your cluster should have same hardware configuration. See, it is recommended by Oracle, and if you try to deviate from it, you will see a lot of performance issues. So it's always recommended that whatever model or whatever company server you take or whatever configuration server you purchase for your node one, it should be the same configuration for all the nodes in the cluster. So do not deviate from it. You can configure it, but definitely you will have performance issues. And also same operating system configuration. Today, right now, Oracle does not support multi-OS clustering solution. So you cannot create a cluster by installing Linux on first node and installing Windows on second node and then install Clusterware software on top of it. It's not possible. You need to have the same OS on all the nodes. Maybe in future, Oracle might release a solution like that. Application software runs on each node. Okay, with this statement, it's not specific to the application which will be using your database. More or less, it is related to your database software or the Clusterware software. So basically, each node will have the Clusterware software. Each node will have the Oracle Home installed over there. So that's why this is not related to the application team. It is related to our Oracle database and Grid software. So you need to install the Grid software and the Oracle Home on each node. You cannot have one node installation and then continue. The second component of cluster is nothing but our Clusterware software, without which the multiple nodes cannot work as one node. It's the software that makes the cluster. It's not the nodes that become cluster automatically. It's the Clusterware software that makes them a cluster, and it manages the workload. As we have already seen in our last session, it's the job of Clusterware software to distribute the incoming connections to the nodes. The job of Clusterware software is to maintain a repository where it knows that, okay, what is the load on node 1? What is the load on node 2? And depending on the load, the new incoming connections are given to the particular node. And even let's take your node 1 is down, then the Clusterware software is responsible for pushing the new connections directly to node 2. That's the job of Clusterware software, where it manages the workload. Again, it manages the nodes. So sometimes what happens, let's take your nodes are evicted. There is a term which is used in RAC, that is node eviction. The meaning of node eviction is sometimes your nodes will go out of the cluster. Now it's the job of the Clusterware software to restart the nodes and join them back into the cluster. That's how Clusterware software will manage the nodes. And there are few things that we'll understand in the Clusterware architecture, where you will understand how Clusterware software manages the nodes. So the Clusterware software is responsible for providing high availability. So how does it perform or provides high availability? Let's take there are 10 nodes in the cluster and 9 nodes are down. If a user sends a request, the Clusterware software will try to check with node 1, it's down. It will check with node 2, it's down. It will check with node 3 and continue till node 9. and after 9 also it won't revert back to the user saying that nodes are down. It will try its best with every possible node, and we have the 10th node live in the cluster, and the Clusterware software will get it executed over there and gives the results to the user. So that way the Clusterware software provides high availability. It never reverts back to the user saying that, boss, your request landed on node 1 and node 1 is down, we can't help. This is how your Clusterware software basically provides the high availability. And of course we have to install it on every node. If you don't install the Clusterware software on every node, it won't be part of the cluster. Simple as that. It makes multiple servers look like one server. Now you guys might have a question over here, like how a cluster is look like one big machine to the outside world. So basically what happens is you assign a name to a cluster and you communicate to the cluster using that name. You do not give any IP address, you do not give any local or physical name of the each node. You just give a cluster name. The Clusterware software will then allocate the work. So let us look at this point. What and how the user connection happens in RAC we'll talk later. Let us understand the cluster working in a generic term. These are your user connections. Your users are connecting to the cluster. So on any cluster or wherever you install the Clusterware software, let's take you have installed the Clusterware software on 4 nodes. All these nodes are connected and they are speaking to the shared storage as well. Right? So whatever clients who try to connect to your cluster, they will have a cluster name. Let's take myrac.oraclegenesis.com. This is the cluster name. So clients will send their queries to this cluster name, and this cluster name is basically assigned to your Clusterware software. So once the client request comes to this Clusterware name, the job of the Clusterware software or the grid software in our case would be to allocate the work to the respective nodes. The best part about the Clusterware software is it knows the load on each node, and then it will try to send the work or allocate the work to the particular nodes. The Clusterware software, or nothing but the grid, is the one who basically gives work to your nodes. It is not the client. Client will never directly interact with the node. Client will just send a request to a name, the cluster name or a host name, and that name is nothing but your Clusterware software name. The Clusterware software will then decide by itself where to send this request. The same way happens in the response time. Let's take the work is given to node 1. Node 1, on physical node you have database instance. It will talk to the shared storage. It will get the required blocks into the instance, and from the instance it is given back to the user. This is generic working of a clustering software. So this is the reason for the outside world, whatever applications you have, it will have only one connection name. Now the application does not know that whether this is a single host, whether this is a RAC software, whether this is a cluster, or whether it is one server, one single desktop, nothing. The outside world is just bothered to send their queries to this particular name, and from this name the work is done. So why it is called as highly scalable? Because let's take, even though my cluster is up and running, I can add nodes to the cluster again and again without impacting the existing cluster and without impacting the users. The same way, let's take I want to reduce the cluster, I can remove the nodes from the cluster without impacting the existing cluster and without impacting the users. Because when you remove the node from the cluster, your Clusterware software is aware that, okay boss, node 3 is removed, and do not give any work to node 3. You have only node 1 and node 2 with you to get the work done. So Clusterware software will allocate work to node 1 and node 2. When you add nodes to the cluster, then your Clusterware software is smart enough, okay, we have two more nodes. So next time new connections will come, we will give it to node 3 and node 4. So that is why Clusterware software job is to manage the entire work within the cluster. And finally, grid, Clusterware software developed by Oracle. Next cluster component that we have is shared storage. We know the importance of shared storage, and if we do not have shared storage, we will be getting into a trouble called as node dependency. So let's take, if we install entire database on node 1 and other nodes are connecting to node 1, then it becomes node dependent. If something happens to your node 1, you can't access your database. So RAC is a shared everything architecture, and how can you share? If you put things on shared storage, it removes single node dependency and accessible by all nodes, multi-node read-write permissions, acts as volume manager and file system. Like, what is the volume manager, what is the file system, and all this will be addressed when we are under ASM topic. So for now, just understand that shared storage is the area where we push all the files and every node can access it. Takes care of redundancy. Okay, administers storage, disk and disk groups. Oracle RAC is shared everything architecture. Guys, these 3 points that we have, this is more related to Oracle ASM. So I won't talk about them right now. And finally, the networks. Networks, we are pretty much good with the network. Each node must be connected to network, minimum 2 or more local area networks recommended. See, it depends on the cluster. Some clusters might require more than 2 network also. They might require 2 private networks. When we say 2 private network, 1 private network for inter-node communication and another private network for shared storage communication. It depends on the cluster to cluster. But Oracle RAC needs only 2 networks. One is public and one is private network. Now there are further networks that we need to configure, that is virtual IP, scan IP. Those 2 networks we will be looking at when we are in the networking configuration. So for now, I won't talk about virtual IP, scan IP, scan listeners or local node listeners, because we are focused towards the cluster component. So I'm trying to keep things as simple as possible because I don't want to confuse you guys at initial stage.